Now, why am I here again?
We're just going to figure that out real quickly.
Okay. Yo, that's hot.
Circle, we decided to have just a little bit of more fun and have all of us staff each create our very own fundraising page. Well, what do I do when I need an idea? I call Benji. And Benji says, I know what we're going to do. We are going to create a video called Chot Ones. And he called a friend of his that he wanted to torture just a little bit. Enjoy.
My name is Benji Rosenzweig. I am a friend of Basi and Levi Shemtov's. Basi called me and asked me if we had any creative ideas for fundraising this year for the Friendship Circle. And I said, I got a good idea. Let's put together some kosher hot sauces and recreate the show Chot Ones, and we'll call it Chot Ones. So we got to find somebody who we like, who's a little bit rambunctious, who's got a voice, can make us laugh, and can handle some hot sauce. So I called my old friend Howard Schwartz and said, Howard, you in? What did you say?
I'm in.
So we're here. We've got some vegan chicken nuggets. We got some hot sauce. We got some water. We got some cashew milk. And we got a bunch of questions to ask Howard. And we're gonna see how this goes. Let's start off with the first one. This is truffled hot sauce because only the best for Howard.
When Benji called me and asked me if I'd participate and if I knew any guinea pigs, I said, oh, isn't that funny? We just bought a farm. I'm the only guinea pig we got so far. All right, let's try our first one. What is this called now?
This is truffled hot sauce. So this is chilies and truffles.
What was the price tag on this?
This was about $8.
$8, that's right up there.
It's classy.
You ready?
L'chaim.
That's lovely.
It's lovely. Delicious. Easy peasy.
More like a little bit of mango in it.
Let's see if he's right.
Of course I'm right.
There's no mango, but that's probably the artificial flavors.
Well, that would be at the bottom. Yes.
All right, so first now, question.
Oh, yeah.
You've been a supporter and friend of Friendship Circle for a long time, longer than even I have been. What got you involved with Friendship Circle, and why do you care?
Well, I became friends with a gentleman named Rabbi Beryl Shemtov, and he introduced me to his son-in-law and daughter. And I got involved because they were good people, and that was about 25 years ago. Now, if you ask me why I care, I would tell you that Bossy's cooking is outstanding. And the work she does is remarkable. So we got involved. For many years, we're very happy to be part of the family.
It's a reasonable answer.
Right.
All right. Sauce number two is Louisiana style hot sauce from La Preferida. I don't know if I pronounced that right. Do you?
Louisiana style. Yes, I know that sauce. Yeah.
I've had this many times.
Oh. Now you gotta shake it up there, boy.
I apparently am not a pro. We're gonna edit that part out.
Okay. It's so hard to say voila, let's just say hors d'oeuvre. Now that's a regular, standard, very conventional, delightful hot sauce that...
Nothing wrong with that.
Won't get to your esophagus until you go to sleep.
Exactly. This is the alternative Tabasco, if you will.
Yeah, it's mild though, yeah.
So you you talked about how you got to Friendship Circle.
Yeah.
Since you got to Friendship Circle, the programming has gone from a couple to more than you can count on your hands, and you'd have to take off your socks and shoes to be able to count all the programs.
What makes you think I got any money for socks?
You can count with your shoes on. That's impressive.
Yeah.
What's your favorite program? What are the programs that really speak to you? I guess favorite is a tough word, but what are the programs that really speak to you?
Well, little known, and I don't want you to repeat this.
Just us.
I belong to the secret society of the Levi Shostak, of the Levi Shem Tov contributors. And that's when you give him a check and he allows you to post-date it for over 18 months. Very important secret group that, now that you know about it, you'll be able to tell them.
Apparently I was just inducted.
valuable, very small secret society.
I got kicked under the table.
Yeah, yes. So that's one of my favorite programs. And ever since I bounced my first check with him, he's been very kind to me.
Friendship House, You Matter, Friendship Circle, Soul Center, Dakota Bakery. What speaks to you? What program do you see and you say, I am grateful that I get to participate in this?
I didn't know I was going to be involved in a commercial. I will tell you that we've been a big fan of Dakota Bread. My favorite institutional program that Bossy Shemto's been running is dinner at her house on Friday nights. Watching their kids grow up was quite a beautiful moment in our lives. I would think that watching the parents pick up their children was one of the most important moments in seeing how important the work the Friendship Circle does to give relief and help to those families.
Can I share a quick story with you?
Of course. Am I going to stop you?
You can try. This week, my daughter Ella, who's 10 years old, was at Friendship Circle camp, and my wife Sarah got a text message from a volunteer who showed a picture on her phone of her on Tuesday with Ella and her when she started volunteering when Ella was 3 or 4 years old, and it was the same pose, and she was so proud to be able to say, I've been volunteering this long. And she's using Ella's growth as a measuring stick for how long she's been volunteering at Friendship Circle. It was a really cool experience that we had there.
I've been volunteering so long, it was before I got my license.
All right, we got sauce number three here.
Yeah.
Cajun Sunshine, hot pepper sauce. This is also cayenne peppers.
I went to high school with that girl's daughter. Keep going.
She's memorable.
Oh, yeah. Will there be any memory, though? Whose idea was it to put this fire over here? Somebody had to light a fire under my hot sauce.
You ready?
Yes, I'm ready. Yes. Bon appetit. Drowns out the flavor of these fake chicken nuggets.
Yeah, not bad for fake.
No, these are not bad. Yeah, right.
My next question for you is, you spoke about Beryl Shemtov, your relationship with Beryl, and how he introduced you to the Friendship Circle. It's no secret that you're a friend of Chabad locally, across numerous different Chabad houses and in other cities and other states. What is it about Chabad that you appreciate, that you feel a kinship to?
Well, they'll take a post-dated check, and the work they do is each and individually expressed in the dedication they have to the Jewish people. And I think that that's remarkable. These are the best salespeople in the world.
Friday boys are relentless.
And if you think I'm kidding, just stop by my office Thursday or Friday at a 3 o'clock appointment. You'll see our boys, right?
There you go.
Well, Benji, for once, you're making me nervous. Keep going. What do we got next?
Well, now we're going to Texas Pete Original Hot Sauce. This is a... I have no idea what kind of pepper this is, but we've gone from the triple-digit Scoville level to the four-digit.
Well, I hope this ends up better than Anthony Bourdain. Okay. You ready?
Let's do this.
Fine. It's pleasant. Got a little bit of vinegary taste to it.
Vinegary. It's loose. It's not real sharp. Howard, you're a connoisseur of fine foods. We have shared many a meal together, both home cooked and in restaurants all over the state.
Although
I've never had
a meal home cooked by your wife.
That is incorrect.
What was that?
You've just never had it in the house. I have brought meals to the office, and we have shared numerous meals.
Correct, but you told me you cooked every one of them.
I lied.
I don't think so.
I wouldn't say that on camera.
Continue, Benji. Let me help you out.
What is the best kosher meal you've ever eaten?
Oh, clearly the ones in New York, the ones in...
No. A specific meal at a specific restaurant or somebody's house. What is that dish that you said, this is it, this is the best one I've ever had?
Well, that would begin with Bossy's purple cabbage
salad. With the green olives?
With the green olives.
And the red dot things?
And the peppers and the sesame, the sunflower seeds. Oh, yeah. That's now a staple in our house.
Moving out of the Bossy world.
Yeah.
Give these folks something that they may not have tried before.
If you think ahead of time and you're prepared, you can bring a kosher pack of hot dogs to the county fair and they'll make corn dogs for you and it'll be terrific. I've never tried that.
You're not going to answer the question, are you?
No. What is the question?
The
Sorry.
Question is, what is the best meal, best kosher meal that you've ever eaten?
The last one.
We'll stop there.
Maybe.
This is a classic. Everybody knows it. Everybody loves it. This is the sriracha.
A staple in my home.
Fine.
Oh, very nice. Very nice.
Reminds me of home.
It reminds me of my favorite dim sum restaurant.
Which is that?
The kosher one up on 15 and Orchard Lake Road.
You know who knows every dim sum restaurant in town?
No, who?
Mark Siegel.
Yeah, that would make sense.
Mark Siegel, that man can tell you. Every Chinese restaurant in town is unbelievable. I tell him I'm out in 26 Mile and wherever. He goes, oh, there's a kosher restaurant, Little Kim's, and tell Mary I say hello. And I say, bless you.
That's the good housekeeping seal of approval.
I got another question for you.
Hold on, let me wipe my brow. Go ahead. What is it? Yo, so, this is good hot sauce.
COVID changed the way that people eat. People go to restaurants, the way that people cook at home. Tell me about your family and how you guys changed your eating habits during COVID.
Well, we carried in a lot. What was good about COVID is that I was able to send other people to the grocery store so I didn't have to go out myself. I sheltered in place for several months. And my wife wiped down every single bag that came into the house, every can, every bottle, yep. All the outside of the fruit, and forgot to bathe the children. But other than that, it was a long haul of eating home and not having a lot of prepared foods.
Any new recipes that you guys are big fans of now?
Not anything absolutely essential to any changes that COVID's brought on.
We got very comfortable with some curries and chutneys and tandooris in my house that we weren't used to before. So,
the difficulty for me is that since my wife bought the farm, I haven't had a home-cooked meal in over 3 months. So that's a post-COVID.
But when it comes, it'll be marbled beautifully.
Oh, beautifully, yes. Especially since we don't eat horses. Keep going. All right, let's see. What do we got here?
Next, we got the Israeli hot Thai chili sauce.
Oh, very nice.
Compliments of my cousin David Bodner in New York.
Oh, very nice. Now, you said this was a sweet chili sauce?
This is a sweet hot chili sauce.
I can see by the color, the sugar glistening. Oh, that is just like a bad Chinese food restaurant. Oh, perfect. This should be over here. Yeah.
There's very little heat. That's now, mostly sweet.
What number was that?
So,
what, on the heat scale.
So I did some research there. It wasn't on the official list, but from the ingredients, I thought it was going to be about 7,500. Looks like it's about 75. They're delicious. Just
that
not
was
hot.
That was your sister's SAT score?
Essentially.
Yeah. Okay.
Right.
Very good.
I got a very interesting question for you. Mm-hmm. Can you tell us the story of Pete Townsend and the corned beef sandwich?
It starts off with Pete Townsend writing a biography. And so when I read it, I learned that he had an affinity to Jewish people. So I said to my wife, would you cook him a Jewish meal like we do on Passover, and I'll see if I can bring it to him when he plays at the concert in Detroit. He says I would. So I called his editor, got a hold of him, Jewish boy, and he put me in touch with Pete's secretary, Nicola, who's very efficient. And Nicola says, it's really hard to get food into a venue. Thank you, it's very kind of you. Maybe I can, you know, comp you some tickets for your generous offer. And I says, that'd be lovely. And she called me back about a week and a half later, says, listen, if you want to bring Pete a Jewish dish, bring him some pastrami. So we did, and he told the secretary, don't forget the pickles.
Don't forget the pickles.
Yes. So the Steak Delicatessen was the provider, and he sent me a beautiful thank you note.
And we got to go to that concert together.
Because I took the tickets they gave me for free and gave you my tickets.
Yeah. And we got to go to the concert together. We got to get some great pictures.
It was great.
Do you still have the big pictures blown up in your house?
Yeah,
in your
sure.
office?
Yeah, sure. Yeah.
I've got the Leslie Amp picture.
Oh, yeah.
Still.
Now, you still have that? Yeah,
I still have that.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah, big the Leslie Slee app, and I showed you the YouTube videos of how they make that thing
how
work.
They make that sound. Yeah, that was very cool. Yeah.
All right, next we've got tiger sauce, and this is a more of a barbecue-style cayenne peppers. So this has got some...
Where is the L'chaim? So you didn't bring those? Those would have livened up the movement. Yeah.
Those would have livened things up, yeah, but I got Christmas plans, so I can't do L'chaim.
Oh, I see,
today.
Right, yes. And I got to catch a theater next flight out. Okay, what tiger sauce? Here's the tiger sauce with little red flecks of pepper.
Fine.
That's nice. Is that this right here?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice.
That's good. You got a little bit of kick?
Yeah, I'll put that in my pocket.
That's actually okay because I accidentally bought two of them.
You bought two of them? Yeah. I'll take that home.
Yeah. Enjoy. It's on the house.
All right, now what else we got?
Question? That was actually the perfect segue into my question about your affinity for Groucho Marx.
Oh. Well, ever since I was a young kid, I thought Groucho was my spiritual idol. And then the resurgence he had in the 70s was perfect timing for high school. And in high school, he was a big hit. And he's taught me a lot, and philosophically has embraced many things in my life. I live by his philosophy, even though he was no comparison to Maimonides. But he espoused, and I accepted, that if you find something funny in everything, life becomes quite amusing. So,
like that.
There it is.
There it is.
And as I've said to you many times in the office, these are my values, and if you don't like those, we have others.
Values or offices?
Values.
Gotcha. All right, Howard, we're about to kick it up a notch here. We got the bone-sucking sauce. This is another one of the barbecue-style hot sauces. We got some hiccup and hot habanero sauce here.
Mm-hmm. And the bone-sucking brand, Talking Serious. Yeah.
Chaim.
Oh, that's good. No, that's hot.
That kicks you right at the end.
Let's put the kick in the middle. Let's go.
Let's do it.
Let's go. You have another question for me?
I do. This is like the sauce, a little bit more serious.
Mm-hmm.
we've been friends for
at least 3 weeks.
15 years. Uh-huh. We were associates in business for 5 years.
Was it that long? It only seemed like 6 weeks.
It was almost 5 years, four and a half years.
Where were you most of the time? You were hiding.
I was making sure that I was making my calls in the basement so that I can keep my job. Mm-hmm. You only yelled at me once. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you remember that time.
No, I don't.
The one time you yelled at me was when we were driving in the car together. Mm-hmm. I was driving. My phone rang. Uh-huh. It was my father. Uh-huh. And you saw on the screen that it said Yussel Rosenzweig. It didn't say dad. Uh-huh. And you got mad.
Because you didn't pick it up.
Because I wasn't respecting my father, and I didn't have it as dad in my phone. And you told me I needed to respect my father. I also watched your interactions with your father many times, and the level of respect that you have for him is something that most parents would dream of. Tell me a little bit about what that comes from and how that works and what you wish other people knew about respecting their parents.
Well, a child's parents have a special responsibility, and my parents took that responsibility very seriously. And with that, I always didn't get along with my dad. And from that, as I got older, I learned to appreciate him. And as life got to move on, we got closer and closer and closer. And now that he's gone, I think about him all the time. And we remember him constantly. And so while your parents are alive, and while you have the good opportunity to be with them, use your phone, put them on video, take pictures and camera of the shtick, the funny parts, the off-color parts, and those will help you later in life when they're gone to share with others and to remember, to have your children remember them by. But appreciation for what your parents did with you, for you, and to you will only come when you get maturity and appreciation toward the obligations a father and mother have to a child. If that's too serious, let's go on to the next hot sauce.
What's your dad's name?
Chaim. Chaim Ben Svi.
All right, we are in the back nine here. We got the Yucatan Sunshine Habanero Peppers.
Mm-hmm.
You ready, Howard?
It's about $9 at Whole Foods.
It's about $6 a plum.
Not possible. Well, that looks good, Ben. I sure hope I got some watermelon in my house to cool my mouth down on the way to get home.
I got watermelon. You come over to my house.
I don't have the gas money to get there.
Fine.
Mmm. Mmm, 0 calories and almost 105 grams of or milligrams of sodium. Mmm, that's perfect for a heart doctor. Oh, that's good. Oh, that's good.
I think the lesson that we're learning here is that we need to start these conversations right around here and get a couple more hotter for the back nine, for the next time.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I agree. I agree.
When we were working together, when I was working for you in your office, there was a sign over the printer that said, "Success is the sum of small efforts repeated day in and day out," by Robert Collier.
Yeah, I never remembered that sign, but you put it up?
I'm pretty sure you put it up, and it was attributed to Albert Einstein.
I don't remember.
I researched it. It was Robert Collier.
From Collier's International?
There may be a connection.
Yeah.
What are the consistent actions that you take that you can hang your hat on for your success?
Well, number one, I wake up in the morning.
Important.
Number two, I go to bed early.
Important.
And number three, a good dose of appreciation toward the life that you are here to lead brings you to realize that we're in service to others. Now, that may be hard to you, for you to remember.
But I got a recording.
But you do have a recording, yes. So I would say to you, the most important part is getting up in the morning. Showing up's 50% of the battle.
Now, if you were to give me
two more things that you do consistently. Zafgain. Consistently. Well, I hate to break it to you, Ben, but there's very little I do consistently. You know, I put the fill in.
Nothing if not honest.
Yes, yes. So I would say to you, what's the next question?
We need more hot sauce.
More hot sauce. Bring it on. Right, bring it.
This is where the rubber meets the road.
Yeah,
that's what this is. Melinda's habanero wing sauce. I looked this up on the Scoville level. We're at 350,000 or so.
I remember going out with Melinda once.
350,000 Scoville worthly?
No, I picked her up in Southfield. Oh, nice. Oh, I can't wait, Benji. I'm so excited. This reminds me a little bit of my grandmother's cooking. What Everything's kind? Burnt. Not that hot.
Not that hot. I was expecting.
No.
Kicks you a little bit after.
Oh, that was good. Oh, yeah, that was good.
What's the best business advice you've ever gotten?
Well, I got advice many years ago. I passed it along to very few people, but I'll pass it along to you.
And you.
The main thing is to keep the main thing the main thing. That's the best business advice that I got, and I pass it along.
Who said that?
Robert Main.
I don't know who that is.
Oh, he was a great philosopher and sage that in most towns there's a street named after him.
We're going to do the old-fashioned Google. Lips are burning a little bit.
My head's burning a little bit.
We'll come back to this.
Okay.
It's not pulling up.
There is no Robert Main. All right, I'd like to pledge my royalties to the Friendship Circle, so let's continue.
This is our final hot sauce.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, I love the final
hot sauce. This is the ghost pepper wing sauce.
Oh, this ought to be significant.
They said this was 577,000 on the Scoville level, or so. Mm-hmm. Let's see how we do.
Oh, yeah.
Ready?
Yep.
L'chaim.
L'chaim.
It's hot. Again, kicks you right after.
I'm sorry I wouldn't answer your question. My wife won't let me talk with my mouth full. yeah, that was really nice. That was really nice.
I'm going for one more.
Yeah, go right ahead. That was great.
We're going to do a little segment here called If This Was a Yiddish Word.
Okay.
I'm going to tell you a word. It's not Yiddish.
Okay.
But if it was a Yiddish word, what would it mean?
Okay, go ahead.
Far-fetched.
Verblunted.
Sheboygan.
Verflechte.
Shih Tzu.
Pooch.
Schnauzer.
Nazi.
Beatnik.
Little before my time.
Kerfuffle.
Kerflechte.
Gimmick.
Schmendrick.
Perplexed.
Verblungied.
Tumult.
Oy vey.
Pestle.
Pestle.
Perplexed.
A guide to.
Arugula.
Very expensive.
Schmuck.
Not me.
Schmendrick.
Never been accused.
Howard. It's been a pleasure.
Benji, thank you for inviting me here. Now I can get home, take a shower, go to bed.
Before we go, though.
Yes.
What is something that you hope people know about the Friendship Circle that if they haven't figured it out already, seen it in a video, read it in an article, What do they need to know that may pull at their heartstrings and make them want to donate to the Friendship Circle?
Number one, Levy will always take a post-80 check. Number two, the level of commitment is unprecedented, and the commitment, the staff, the leaders, the volunteers, the parents have to this organization. So may it continue with success for many, many years, and may your first child be a masculine child.
All right.
If you enjoyed this video, please share it with your friends, get the word out there, and go to walkforfriendship.com. You can search anyone's individual fundraising page and donate to help Friendship Circle continue the work that we all do together.
We just finished our first episode of Chot Ones, and I just wanted to relay that, you know, every year that we fundraise for the Friendship Circle, my wife and I do something goofy and try to just create awareness, and it's always a pleasure. We've done crazy things. I've done crazy things from the first time I shaved my head to waxing the Friendship Circle logo into my chest hair to all sorts of other, you know, music and goofy stuff. But when Bossy called me and asked me to come up with an idea, she thought that she was coming up with an idea for her page. What she doesn't realize is that we're commandeering this, and this is also for my page. So Bossy, thank you for this opportunity. Thank you for everything that you do for the kids with special needs, the young adults with special needs, the teens, the volunteers, the folks with addiction, and everybody in between. We appreciate everything that you've done for us, and hopefully with my friends, my family, my circle of influence, the people who see this video, will contribute to the Friendship Circle and show you how much we appreciate you. So please click the link and donate a couple bucks.